Hello, Bloom Perfumery right here. It's been a while, but we've been busy exploring frontiers of the known perfume universe. And we're back with some news and finds. This video will be about challenging scents, scary scents, bizarre scents, or the most bizarre and the most scary and the most challenging ones. For quite a while, the throne of this scary one was occupied by Secretion Magnifique, of course, by Tête Libre d'Orange, a famous or infamous perfume modeled around the aromas of bodily fluids, anything our bodies can produce. Saliva, sperm, milk, blood, sweat, adrenaline, it's all there. But nevertheless, it's a perfectly structured, well-engineered perfume formula. It's just it's made of these crazy notes. Do smell it just to expand your own horizons of what's possible in perfumery. It's seriously like beyond comfort zone of majority of noses, including myself. To me, it feels like you're trying to put metal against glass, that kind of extremely high-pitched sound. So that was the one for me as well, until this came along. Perfume called Sombra, which we keep under Belgium, which says caution. Please ask for assistance. This perfume has notes of vomit, rotten sweat, results of the of life, products of life of nocturnal animals. It's earthy, it's strange. And most people don't even ask us to spray it on the blotter. They do this and they quietly back off. It's an artistic statement. It's not cacophonous, there's logic. It's a perfume just made with bizarre, extreme, off-putting. I asked the perfumer why he would compose something like this. And he said, I wanted everyone to sort of wake up and stop getting perfumes because they say, in the blogosphere or reviewers say, oh, this is gorgeous, I get so many compliments. Just stop for a second and ask yourself, do I really like it? So it's a statement, an experiment, if you wish. And also interaction with customers. To me, it smells like a can of or bin full of nappies. And nappies at the very, very bottom are already in a state of liquid decay, and this is when you start thinking, I should really, really take it out now. It stinks. I'm sorry. But perfumer hates it as well. He himself doesn't really insist on it being something you just don't understand, you know? Like some perfumers, they say, it's wonderful, you just don't understand. He says, it's ugly, try it. Let's like wake up. And again, this moved my frontier a bit further until same perfumer produced something which smells like a portal into the other world. But not the benevolent kind of heaven, the Hades, the underworld inhabited by not so benevolent creatures with very dark souls and intentions. When I smell it, when I put it on, I feel like Nosferatu is hugging me and I can sense the claws on my shoulders. And I haven't met a perfume formula which is as packed with animalic materials as this. There's goat hair. You can wash goat hair to obtain certain kind of oily, interesting animalic smell. There is hyrax, which is hyrakium. The fossilized urine of hyraxes discovered somewhere in an ancient cave in North Africa. There is oud. Oud can have a seriously animalic vibe to it. There is beeswax, another material which can be quite ambivalent in terms of how clean it smells. Myrrh, the corporeal aroma, which in Christian religion, for example, symbolizes the human part of the baby Christ. Remember divine gifts, myrrh, frankincense, and gold. So myrrh was a symbol of human nature of the child. Frankincense was the divine part. And gold was the king over kings symbol. So this moved my frontier even further. And somewhere alongside Homa, there's this beauty called Hue. They're both quite bizarre, but that doesn't give me the creeps. It just smells like a really old piece of wood on floating somewhere in a tropical river, and you're not sure if it's wood or a crocodile, log or a crocodile. So this perfume has extract of seashells, ambergris, extract of seaweed, and Hue is the name of a city of dead kings. So if you were to go in that direction, it's always something to do with body. Fresh, or let's say not so fresh. This is where it gets sort of scary and macabre. Start with Secussion Magnifique. See if you want to go anywhere beyond that. If you do, these are the signposts I personally explored and singled out as the most challenging for myself, and I smell thousands of perfumes in my time. Are they wearable? Yes and no. This is more like Halloween party or some social distancing tool. These are beautiful, but you will need to focus on these two instead of like focusing as on what's going on. They really draw you in like true portals. As if you read that inscription and voila, you are elsewhere, not in this world. Oh, you can smell them here in our boutique in Covent Garden. You can sample them online. Sample is a good way of discovering it without committing to a full bottle. Do people get full bottles? Yes, they do. Everyone is different. Whatever sort of fills your sails with wind, wear it. So our ideology is perfume shall make you happy. Don't just get it because it's fashion or lots of people said it's gorgeous. It's a good way to discover new things, but always ask yourself whether you connect to it. Thank you for watching. Good night. And there'll be more stories soon.